Hi guys, in this video we will be discussing about how to go about the preparation of GATE examination in the last month. So basically, I'll be considering that we have 30 days left for GATE exam. And in these 30 days, we basically have to focus on revision plus test series. Okay? Now, most of you would have completed the GATE course at least once in these months, and if not, then I'll tell you what specific points you can focus on while covering the rest of the GATE course without compromising the revision and the mock test. Basically, if you are still left with the GATE course and you are not left with the time to cover it, then you will have to prioritize. The first priority that I can think of is for the case of maths plus FT, because though you may not realize it, but maths plus FT covers almost 30 marks in GATE examination. So I would suggest that you go for maths plus FT practice in the last month before the GATE examination so that you are safe with the 30 marks. At the same time, going about the revision of the other subjects and practicing mock test. So basically, since we have 30 days left, so you can dedicate almost 2 hours each day for studying maths plus aptitude. In this, the first priority should be for the engineering maths and the second should be for the case of aptitude. Why engineering maths first? Because aptitude is very generic. Even if you do not get much time to practice the aptitude, but you must go for engineering maths. Now, what you can do in the other time, you must go for revision. Then the question arises, how to go about revision? To go about revision, you need some short notes, because if any of you would have attended the classroom program, you will have almost 20 notebooks for 10 subjects. Okay, or you can say almost 300 pages, or we can say 3000 pages for 10 subjects, 300 pages per subject, 3000 pages for 10 subjects. That is almost impossible to revise. So what your objective must be while creating short notes? So first let us talk about short notes. If you want to prepare short notes, your target must be 20 to 40 pages per subject. Now, what does this short note includes? This includes important formulas that are used in problem solving, small concepts that one is likely to miss or you are likely to make a mistake in that. These two components will make up your short notes. And do try to keep legible but small handwriting. Why small handwriting is because that way you will reduce the number of pages, and when you are reading it, it will give you a confidence that you only have to cover a few pages. You don't have to go about a lot of pages. That way, if you have 40 pages per subject, then you can revise 2 subjects per day. Okay, at least like the theory part for that or the revision package, you can just revise 2 subjects per day. That is, it must be covered in a span of 4 hours. Okay, so that is 4 hours for revision, 2 hours for maths and FT. Now what to do in the rest of the time? In the rest of the time, you must go for subject test. Okay, that is, once you revise one subject, then one subject test. Subject test is almost for 1 hour. So this will comprise for 3 hours. So after 3 hours, you must take a break. Let us say you take a break of 1.5 hours, in which what you can do is, Engage in some mind relaxing activity, like you can listen to music or you can sleep. But don't go about interacting or social media, because that will waste a lot of your time. Then again go for one subject revision plus one subject test. Okay, that will again comprise 3 hours. Again take a break of 1.5 hours. So that is a total of 9 hours. Then go for 2 hours maths plus FT session. So that will totally comprise for 11 hours. Okay, which are more than enough for studying. And if you want to study more than that, if you have more time left, then basically what you can focus on is try to solve previous year problems. Okay, because now what happens is GATE is being conducted in multiple sessions. So many a times it is seen that many of the problems will be repeated in the GATE examination from the previous year. So it is very necessary that you are very well versed with the previous year problems, so that you can directly attempt those without any hesitation. So that also you can include in your schedule. Now let us discuss what kind of schedule you can keep. So basically you should divide your schedule into two parts. That is odd days and even days. Okay. Now on odd days, what you can do is you can go for mock test. First of all, your mock test will be the true indicator of your performance. Why? Because there you are attempting 10 subjects at a single time. So you will know how to manage your time. And it is extremely useful and it is compulsory that you go for mock test. You cannot go to GATE examination without practicing mock test. Okay? If you are not giving mock test, actually you are wasting a year long preparation of yours. Do not think that I am not ready with all the subjects. Do not think that I haven't still revised. You have to go for mock test at any cost. Why I am suggesting this is, suppose even if you are ready with 5 subjects, even if you are getting a score of 40 to 50 marks, you should analyze your performance in only those 5 subjects. Do not think that I am not getting a good percentile, I am not getting a good rank, I am embarrassing myself. There is no embarrassment if you are getting low scores, because at least it is telling you where you lie at present. You should go on improving that, then only you can move ahead. Otherwise, if you are even unknown, if you are not even aware about your performance, then how will you rectify it? Do try to think in that manner. Mock test is not actually a test for you, it is actually a practice session in which you are spending 3 hours to practice all the subjects at a single time. Okay, so that is how you will have to give mock test on each odd day. So you can actually give 15 to 20 mock tests in a span of 30 to 40 days. Now after giving a mock test, the next step should be analyze. What you have to analyze? First of all, try to take a count of your negative marking. How many negative marks you got? Then take a count of percentage of accuracy. What was your accuracy? Because remember, in GATE examination, the attempt percentage is not that important as the accuracy is. Because even if you are attempting more, but you are attempting incorrect, then it is of no use. Then analyze subject wise marks, because once you analyze subject wise marks, you will know where you are lacking, which subject is weaker. Then what to do on even days? Try to revise your weaker subjects. Just I told you about the revision strategy, that you will have to revise by your short notes and then practice a subject test, but you must focus on your weaker subjects in that. Okay, then you will practice maths plus FT. Then when on the next odd day you will be giving a mock test, you have to see the improvement in your subject which was weaker in the last test. Okay, So here you have to focus on self-improvement. Never go on comparing your score with your friends, because that will either overexcite you, which will give you a false sense of confidence that you are ahead of them, so you will easily be able to clear gate examination, or it will give you a negative thought that you are lying behind them, so you won't be able to clear the exam. Just focus on yourself in this last month. Focus on your performance. Just try to observe whether or not you have improved from the last examination. In what terms you should improve? In terms of percentile or AIR. Okay? Why? Because even if you are not improving in terms of marks, the one probable cause for that is the test may have been difficult. It may have had a higher level than the previous examination. So the score might actually go down, but your percentile and AIR must improve. That way, if you constantly focus on this feedback loop in which you are judging your performance and then wasting your efforts in improving that performance, you will definitely be improving in this last month. So this last month will actually act as a rank booster for you if you plan your studies in such a manner. Some of the points that you must take care, those are non-technical points in this last month, is, first of all, you have to eat and sleep well. Do not compromise your sleep. Why? Because generally, if you get ill in this crucial time, then you will be losing a lot of days, and that will not help you in your gate preparation. So you will have to eat and sleep well in the last month so that you remain healthy and you can focus on your preparation. Secondly, no social media interaction. Actually, what happens is, whenever we go about social media, whether it is Facebook or WhatsApp, we do not quite take a hold of the time that we are losing. We do not have an estimate of that. We are overspending the time and even we don't realize that. Even if you are going on social media, that should be for a fruitful cause, or that should be for a positive cause like doubt solving. Okay. There are many Facebook groups for doubt solving, and the most or the best group is the Gate Aspirants. That is the most active group, which you can search online by the URL facebook.com/creatrix. Okay, so this is the most active group. Here you can ask your doubts. That way your time on the social media will be well spent instead of being wasted. Next is that you should stay away from negativity. That is, many people will be taking you to the negative road. That is, they will be telling you that we cannot do anything in the last month, we have wasted our entire year, and all those kind of thoughts. No. Still a lot of time is left. You can do a very much in this last month. Do not give up. Do not give up at any cost, because you are giving up on your career. And if you have a habit of giving up, you will never lose this habit. You will be giving up in your life at each and every situation. This is the point where you can make your mark. This is the point where you can give your best. This is the point where you can boost your rank. Okay? This is not the time to give up. You have come a long way. And if you continue only up to 1 month, you may see some good results. You may see how your career will proceed. Okay? So stay away from such people who will say that you cannot do anything in this 1 month. Even if you haven't done anything up till now, still you can go ahead. No need to give up. Think about the next year later on after the gate examination, but right now your only focus should be the gate exam. Do not think any further than that or any before that. You have to think only and only about the gate exam. No need to think about the results. Okay? Because what happens is, most of the times we will be considering what will come in our result, how I will fare in the gate examination. That will be wasteful and it will lead you to depression. You cannot control the result. The thing that you can control is, you can only control the effort that you put in your preparation. You can only control that. So try to give best in that. Results will automatically follow. And the last is, time management. Do make a strict schedule for yourself and do not overstress yourself. Do not make a schedule which you cannot follow over a longer period. Make a schedule which has a balance between the studies as well as the mind relaxing activities. May it be a movie at the end of the day. Do not think that you cannot watch movies or have some fun. But if you have spent the entire day working towards your GATE examination, then only you have a right to see the movie or do some mind relaxing activity at the end of the day. Secondly, never focus on a single subject throughout the entire day. Why? What happens if I have the entire day for a single activity, then I will be lenient on myself. Why? I will think still there are a lot many hours left. I will follow that. Right now I can relax. I'll do it later because the entire day is left. But if you have given a single subject only 2 to 3 hours, you know you have to complete this within this time only. You don't have any more time. That way your efficiency will increase many folds. This is my personal observation. Even when I work, if I have the entire day, then my work is speed is very less. But if I have only 2-3 hours, my speed goes up by a very good amount. Okay. So that way, do not focus on a single subject throughout the entire day. So just I will like to tell you, the mock tests are the most important part of your preparation. Do not underestimate their importance and go about the mock test in a positive manner. The only cycle that you need to follow is attempt a mock test, analyze the result, and then revise based on the subject that you are weak at, and then again go to attempt. If you completely follow this cycle again and again and again over the next 30 to 40 days, you will definitely do well in the GATE examination. Okay, so these are some of the things that you can follow, and do not go about any leftover subjects right now. Only if you have maths or aptitude left, you can go about that. Other subjects will be a lot time consuming and will distract you from the revision process. Now is not the time to study the core subjects, but rather the subjects which have higher weightage and yet the effort required is less. Okay. At last, I would like to wish you all the best for the GATE examination. And I would like to just summarize by saying this is not the time to give up. You can still make it.